Welcome back. You're watching Weekend Live on SABC2. A 300-year-old settlement in Cape Town is once again being put on the spotlight through an exhibition. The exhibition is a collection of works by various artists on the World Cup community. It's underway at Joburg's Bag Factory. Now, we have co-curator Jacob Lebeko to talk to us about the exhibition. Jacob, welcome to Weekend Live.
Morning.
Let's talk about the motivation for this exhibition. Where did it start and who's the creative brain behind it?
All the artists that are on this exhibition, part of a collection called Icabani Art Collection. And the representative, Mr. Omar Valley, actually is the prince behind it, and Dr. Wallace Rote and his wife, they actually put this work to the Bag Factory to say, yes, there's 9 artists, do something and come up with a show. And my role in it was to actually make sense of the whole group of artists and write something about it. Hence the small brochure there.
Now, right now, I mean, if you're looking behind us on the plasma screen, you'll see some of the art that'll be exhibited at the exhibition. But for those that don't really understand or even have a sense of what the Boer Cup is, can you describe it for them?
The actually name Boer Cup was not part of the title, but I put it there just to give a sense of the nature of Cape Town as a colorful community, because the work as well is very colorful. If you think of the Coons Carnival that is happening there, the houses that are very bright. So the artwork itself is about
very colorful.
Yeah, being colorful as well, but it's about the realities of some of the parts of Cape Town where people are struggling. There's poverty, there's all this misery. But I mean, the artists are portraying it in such a colorful way that you even forget that the reality that they are portraying there.
Jacob, take us through some of the works that make up the exhibition.
There's about 9 artists in this exhibition, and all of them, they come from different parts of Cape Town. And the work is about, it's dealing with genres like music. You'll find like also still lives in the exhibition. You'll find also the landscapes of Cape Town. You'll find also some of the political aspects about Cape Town. If you think Victor Verster is also part of the Cape Town city where Mandela was released.
Yeah.
So it's a variety of issues around Cape Town.
Now, I mean, as I'm talking to you, I'm also looking at some of the art that's been displayed on our plasma, and they're really beautiful pieces of work. How were the artists chosen to be part of the exhibition?
The artists were selected randomly, like as I said. Mm. All of them, they belong to this Icabani Art Collection.
Okay.
Yes. And the motivation was also to try and sell some of these works to actually help the artists out.
Mm.
So all the work that is on this show is for sale.
For sure. The one thing that strikes me, and you mentioned that you added the Boer Cup because the collection itself is very colorful, but we are in Johannesburg.
Yes.
How does that translate, though, for an audience here?
Well, the story of Cape Town in this context is not different from what we have in Johannesburg or what we have in Pretoria. You know, it's a national thing, you know. The artists in Cape Town in this context are experiencing the same frustrations as the artists in Joburg.
For sure.
Yeah, so they will actually relate.
Mm.
And on the 21st of April, I just want to add that we are having a panel discussion around these works, and we'll be inviting students from the community, particularly Funda Community Center in Soweto, and some of the students will be coming from Alexandra. So we'll be actually discussing about the issues around the work. And that's when you will actually, the students and the artists will actually engage and share the stories.
Jacob, very quickly, this exhibition has been running since Thursday. What kind of responses have you come across, and what has the response been like?
Actually, on the day of the opening, there was quite a number of young artists from the Market Theatre area, and most of them were quite excited to actually have been there to actually see the work, and I think most of them wanted to talk to me and actually ask about the work, because it was quite a different set of artworks that they were seeing, you know, like the color that is inherent in the work. It's not something that you find all the time in Joburg.
So it's exciting stuff.
Yes.
Jacob, we're going to leave it there, but thank you much for talking to us. That was co-curator Jacob Lebeko of Work Up, the story of the Cape Artists Exhibition, which opened on Thursday, closing later this month at the Bag Factory. And that's in Fordsburg. Go and check it out.